Hi gang, here's a lamp I made by using an electric fly swatter, a tube from a compact fluorescent light, and a clothes hanger. It runs on two AA batteries for just under 4 hours. In this video, I'll show how you can make one too. First, I need just the tube from a CFL. Here are some that I've taken apart. Sometimes you can pry them open, but often you have to cut them open. Be careful not to cut too deeply and damage anything inside. You'll either see electronics like this, or just thin wires like this. In either case, cut the wires so that you leave as long a length as possible going to the tube. Keep the part with the tube. Don't worry, the tube is sealed, so no mercury will get out. Next, I take the fly swatter apart. Here's the circuit board. Not all makes of fly swatters are the same as this, but for many the basic idea is the same. This is the packaging for mine. Here's the schematic. And here's the circuit diagram. The wires going to the meshes are these yellow and red ones. This diode makes the output DC, meaning the electrons are allowed to flow in one direction only. That's bad for a fluorescent tube, since it causes the mercury in the tube to build up at one end. And this resistor would have been reducing the current, possibly mainly for drawing any sparks, which there won't be anymore. So I do some desoldering and soldering. I desolder this end of the resistor and put a black wire in its place. I also desolder this end of this diode and put a red wire in its place. I connect up a 5-watt CFL. There are two wires for each end of the tube, so I make sure to connect to both of them. Which way it goes doesn't matter. Turning it on, it works. I try it with a 13-watt tube that I'd previously soldered wires to. That also works. The circuit diagram now looks like this. I get out my oscilloscope and turn on the light. I've connected my two probes such that they're each measuring one side of the CFL tube with respect to ground. Each individual trace is too high to fit in the display, but is still within the safe voltage range for my scope. When subtracted from each other to show what the CFL would see, it also doesn't fit. The frequency is around 9.259 kHz. From past experience, I may be able to adjust the brightness by using different resistance values here, so I remove the resistor and put in some short wires instead. I attach a potentiometer to those wires so I can adjust the resistance manually. Running it in darker conditions while adjusting the resistance, I search for when it's brightest. That turns out to be around 700 ohms. I also run it like that for a while to see if any parts get too hot. None seem to. I find that an older 820 ohm fixed resistor gives the same light, so I solder that in. The switch that came with it has to be held closed for it to work, so I cut a hole for a new switch and move the wires from the old one to a new one. A quick test shows that it works great. Finally, I desolder the wires going from the board to the mesh. After putting the cover back on, it still works. Next, I find that the tube assembly fits nicely into an old plastic bottle, so I cut the top and bottom from the bottle and fit them together. I then cut a plastic ring out of some scrap plastic until it fits over the bottle parts well. I next drill some holes in it for attaching to the fly swatter, as well as one for hanging the whole thing for convenience. Putting the ring in place, it fits. I hot glue the bottle pieces together. Notice the two small holes in the side. Then comes putting the bottle pieces on the ring, with the wires extending inside through the small holes, and then hot gluing them to the ring. Then the CFL's wires are connected to the fly swatter's wires using morettes, and the CFL tube is put in place. After screwing the cover back on, a final test shows it works. Done. To have some fun with the lamp, I get out a metal clothes hanger and start cutting it up. First, I make a hook for hanging it. I first try hanging it in my closet. In the dark, it works great. I can also hang it from the headboard of my bed and use it as a reading light. I then use the rest of the clothes hanger wire to make a desk stand. I use the light to see my way into my office. And put it in the desk stand on the desk for general lighting. And lastly, one question I've gotten a lot is how long it runs for. To measure that, I put in some fresh batteries and put it in this box. The box has a hole at one end. Inside at the other end is some paper with writing on it. This hole lets me see in with the camera to film the light level. The settings on the camera are all set to manual. I switch on the light, close the box, and start timing it. For the first 3 hours and 40 minutes, it keeps around the same brightness. But when I check 10 minutes later, at 3 hours and 50 minutes, it's much dimmer. Then 15 minutes after that, it's no longer lit. So I get around 3 and 3/4 hours of good light. Well, thanks for watching. See my YouTube channel, rimstar.org, for more fun videos like this. That includes one all about the electric fly swatter, another explaining how a jewel thief circuit works, and to help for anyone new to electronics, one on how to read a schematic. And don't forget to subscribe if you like these videos, or give a thumbs up, share with your social media, or leave a question or comment below. See you soon!